Foreclosure crisis upside down. Instead of the bank foreclosing on a home, a Florida homeowner had deputies foreclose on the bank. The movers rolled in with a truck, an armed deputy standing by, all while the nervous homeowners waited. It's what you'd see when a home is foreclosed on and the property seized by a bank, but this time, the tables were turned.
They've ignored our calls, ignored our letters. Legally, this is the next step to get my clients compensated.
A Collier County judge said Bank of America had to pay Maureen Nyerges and her husband's legal fees after the bank tried to foreclose on their property, but they paid cash. The courts agreed they never had a mortgage to begin with. After more than 5 months, the bank still hadn't paid them $2,500, so the homeowner's attorney did just what the bank would do to get its money, seized its assets.
I instructed the deputy to go in and take desks, computers, copiers, filing cabinets, including cash in the drawers.
Outside the bank, several deputies stood by with movers ready to start hauling out the bank's office supplies and furniture. Inside, the homeowner's attorney was locked out by deputies while the bank manager tried to figure out what to do.
He was visibly shaken. Having two sheriff's deputies sitting across your desk and a lawyer standing up behind them, demanding whatever assets are in the bank, it can be intimidating. But so is having your home foreclosed on when it wasn't right.
After about an hour, the bank finally cut a check.
As a foreclosure defense attorney, this is sweet justice, because this is a symptom of a larger problem.
In a statement, Bank of America apologized to the homeowners and blamed an outside attorney for delaying their payments. And that will do it.